PNG Extra Afternoon Tea is proudly brought to you by Paradise with Cream Biscuits.
On our afternoon tea and gracing us with her wonderful presence is Lavina Williams, a singing sensation who was once on Australian Idol. Thanks so much for joining me today.
Thank you for having me. I'm excited to be here.
So this is your second time in the country, right?
Yes. And I mean, every time I go back home to New Zealand, I'm always bragging about how beautiful PNG is. Papua New Guinea people are so welcoming, and I'm just really happy to be back.
It's a huge pleasure to have you here in Papua New Guinea again. And what is the purpose of your visit in Papua New Guinea?
So I'm here for the St. John's 60th anniversary ball that's happening on Saturday. I'm the entertainment, so I'm going to be having a good old party with everybody and trying to raise awareness, as well as giving back to the people of PNG and just celebrating the people of PNG. Yeah.
Great. And since, you know, I said your introduction, you've been on Australian Idol.
Yes.
Since then, what have been some of the amazing things you've been up to?
Okay, so, well, since Australian Idol, that was back in 2006.
Oh my gosh.
2006, honey. I've done a lot of things. So I've done the Lion King musical in Australia and in Germany and in Singapore. So I was living in Germany for 7 years and writing music for the pop stars Idol, German Idol over there. Some of the contestants also got signed with Warner Publishing. So, that got me very, very busy. Also, on top of that, doing Dreamgirls, playing Dina, Beyonce, as you can tell.
Tixa.
So I did the mini tour in France while I was over there. Yeah. And being a Pacific Islander, and when you're introduced to so many cultures, people can't place you.
Yeah.
You know, and then having to hold the flag for New Zealand, and me being Fijian Samoan.
Because your dad's Samoan.
Samoan,
right?
German, and my mother's Fijian. It was another patriotic moment for me every time I did make a speech or introduce myself, just to introduce the whole country.
Wow.
You know, New Zealand, Fiji, Samoa, because they didn't know where it was on the map. And then I'm having to point, so see that little dot over there? That's Fiji.
Wow.
The other dot to the left is Samoa. And that little island at the bottom of Australia, that's where I live, you know?
Yeah.
So little opportunities like that to introduce my country and where I'm from is a very special, special moment.
And you mentioned Lion King. You were the only non-African, right?
Yes.
To actually play that.
Yes, so Rafiki is one of the lead principal roles of the Lion King musical, and no non-South African actor, singer is allowed to play that because it's very sacred, it's a very spiritual role to play. But as soon as they heard me, I think we have a lot in common when it comes to spiritual, religious backgrounds, and having that real strong belief, you know, and with my upbringing as well. And they saw that and they asked me to play her, which was a great honor.
Wow.
But I was terrified. It's a huge role to play.
Yeah.
But it was a huge honor for me to play a South African witch doctor.
And learning the language and
learning the language. I didn't sleep for months, man.
Wow.
Having to learn the dialect, because South Africa has a lot of dialects, right?
Yeah.
And I'm sure with Papua New Guinea.
Yeah. There's 800 languages.
What?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Forget about it. Yeah, so I did The Lion King. Also, Hairspray. I played Queen Latifah.
Oh, gosh.
And Hairspray, the Hairspray musical. Also, just touring around with Stan Walker and Jenny Blackmore, and writing music for my brother, Jay Williams, which is, he's a huge superstar in New Zealand. And having a musical family. Also, my sister Emily Williams coming second in Australian Idol.
Wow.
So she was runner-up.
So the whole
Australian
family
Idol.
Is a musical.
Yeah. Yes, we're very musical. And like having a real strict upbringing. My father was a youth pastor, and we would always practice. No playtime. There was no computers back then.
Yeah.
That really shows my age, doesn't it? So I'll just stop there. So so that sort of created this work ethic and being a perfectionist, you know, I think it molded us to be the artists that we are today, and to share with everybody coming from nothing.
Yeah.
We had nothing when we were growing up, and I'm sure a lot of people can relate to that, but you got to make something out of nothing.
Yeah.
You can make something so beautiful out of nothing. And my mum taught me that, you know.
So true.
So I'm just glad that I have the privilege and the I'm so glad that I have so much blessings and a lot of people that's supporting me along the way and having the perks of, you know, traveling to these places that we only dream of, you know, and one of them is PNG, which is why I'm very, very grateful to be here.
You know, you touch a bit about the passion and, you know, that's leading on to my next question. You know, the passion behind what you do. You support a lot of causes and, you know, why is that? Is it because of your upbringing?
Yeah, the reason why I always love to give back to the people is because of where I'm from, where I was brought up in South Auckland and we were scraping for food, you know, when we were very young. We had water and bread for breakfast, lunch and dinner, you know, so struggle was very real. And I said to myself, I'm gonna make a stand, use this talent, this God-given talent that I was blessed with, and make something of myself. I refuse to be a stereotype. I'm a very strong, outspoken woman, thanks to my mom and her survival mechanism. And I'm just glad that she survived through, she went through the most horrific experience with my father, and he's not in our life anymore. And I'm like happy to say that, you know, love always wins, you know, and family and making sure that we support each other. No matter what happens to you, you can always make something special come out of it, you know. And look at me, I'm a witness. I'm one of the victims, but I will not use that as an excuse to be a terrible person. This world needs more love in it, and definitely, I want to be a part of it, and I want to contribute to that.
Definitely. Well, it's been an absolute pleasure having you on the show, and, you know, having you back in PNG. I'm excited to hear you sing.
I can't wait for Saturday. So you guys are gonna come on Saturday, because we're gonna bring the rain, okay? Bring the party, okay?
Well, thank you so much for coming on.
Thank you so much.
Okay.